Next is the pneumatic circuit for pick and place applications. Here also we are using the extension and traction. So these are the things happening in hydraulic as well as pneumatic system. That is, the forward and return stroke should be ensured in both the hydraulic and pneumatic systems. When the 5/2 directional control valve is shifted to its left mode by energizing the solenoid, the air flows to the blind end or blank end of the cylinder through the flow control valve FC1, that is flow control valve 1. This extends the cylinder, and so the actuating force is applied on the cam of the gripper, which in turn actuates the gripper jaw to grip the object. Retraction: when the directional control valve is shifted to right mode by de-energizing the solenoid, air flows to the rod end of the cylinder through the flow control valve, that is FCV2. This retracts the cylinder and the gripper ungrips the object. Note: the extensing speed of the cylinder and the actuating force can be regulated by adjusting the air flow in the flow control valve. So this is a pneumatic system, so we have to adjust the airflow control, so it executes the process in a different kind of way. So depending upon the requirement, we can adjust the airflow. So if we adjust the airflow, it have different kind of executions here that should be mentioned here. So pneumatic circuit for tool handling in CNC machine tools, that is numerical control machine tools. So it will be actuated here, the double acting cylinder, clamping and unclamping, rotation of tool, work table, the motor is utilized here, then 4/3 solenoid, a spring based valve with DC directional control valve, 4/2 solenoid operated directional control valve, FRL unit, filter, regulator, lubricator. We know very well filter is used. So filter the uncontaminated components in air. So that's why we use filters. So if we use the system without filter, it harm the system. Then regulator. So it regulates the flow in a right direction, in a right flow, so whatever maybe we can specify. Then lubricator: when a system moves, means it has generate some heat, that should heat should be overcome by, so providing the proper setup to transfer the heat in a right way. So then only the system maintain the constant temperature. If we not provide the lubrication system in a right way, the system get heated up, then the system get stopped its process, or it get harm the system. So that's why we used to provide the proper lubrication system. So this is the system executed by FRL. So it execute both, filter the air and regulate the airflow, as well as the lubricate the air. So all the things to be carried out in a FRL unit. So this is the main criteria here. Then cylinder operation: when the solenoid of 4/2 DCV is energized, air flows into the blank end or blind end of the cylinder, and the cylinder extends to the clamp, workpiece or tool we have specified here. When the solenoid of 4/2 valve is de-energized, the air flows into the rod end of the cylinder and the cylinder retracts, so that the unclamp the workpiece. Then cylinder operation is specified here, then motor operation is specified here. So when the solenoid of 4/3 valve, directional control valve, is energized, air flows into the inlet port of the air motor and the motor rotates. The motor rotation is used to rotate the tool. When the solenoid of 4/3 directional control valve is de-energized, the motor rotates in the opposite direction. So this is the thing. So here there is no forward and return stroke, so it rotate in one direction. If you make them two in opposite position, it will rotate in the just opposite direction. Note that the operation of pneumatic cylinder and motor is synchronized based on the application requirement through the part program. So here the operation of both pneumatic cylinder, so the cylinder it provides only the forward and return strokes manually. So whether it may be pneumatic system or hydraulic system, or pneumatic system or hydraulic system, auto maybe. But it have execute the two system, that is one forward stroke or in a return stroke. These two things only considered in a cylinder base. So whereas in motor it rotate in a clockwise direction or in anti-clockwise direction. If you want forward stroke, it should be in a clockwise direction. If you want to rotate in anti-clockwise direction, we have to use the return stroke. So forward stroke. So we again rotate in a clockwise direction, we get forward stroke. If it rotate in anti-clockwise, we get the return stroke. So this is the thing here specified.